Samsung has almost perfected the foldable phone over the last few years, and its upcoming Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 5 is expected to be even better than the current models in its flagship foldable range. We're not expecting to see the device until quite late in 2023, so there aren't too many rumors about just yet. But we have heard a few tidbits, along with information on the phone's possible release date and price. There's only been a handful of real Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 5 leaks so far, with the first one pointing to the foldable having a Snapdragon 8 Gen 2 chipset. That would be the successor to the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 and Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 chipsets that power many of 2022's best Android phones, including the Galaxy Z Fold 4. So either the Gen 2 or a Plus version of it always seemed likely. The same source also suggests the phone will have a triple lens rear camera with a 50 megapixels main sensor. That's exactly what the Fold 4 has, with the other two sensors being a 12 megapixels ultra-wide and a 10 megapixels telephoto, so this might mean there aren't many upgrades to the camera. Secondly, the phone is apparently getting a water drop shape hinge, enabling the two sides of the device to lay completely flat against each other. That would improve the durability of the foldable in theory. This has since been backed up by a second report, which adds that the phone will be waterproof. For Samsung to make the ultimate foldable phone, there are five key things it needs to do. First, the same cameras as the Samsung Galaxy S23 Ultra. The cameras on the Z Fold 4 aren't bad at all, but they aren't Samsung's best, despite it being the company's most expensive phone. Anyone who can spare the sort of money the Z Fold 4 costs is likely to want the best of the best, and on the camera front, it just doesn't manage that. So for the Fold 5, we want the phone to match the camera configuration of the Samsung Galaxy S23 Ultra, which based on past form probably will have the company's best snappers. Next, no visible crease. As impressive as Samsung's foldable screens are, the company hasn't cracked the crease, with it being visible and something you can feel when you swipe across the display. This isn't a big deal, and is something most people will quickly get used to, but is an imperfection in an otherwise excellent screen, so we'd like to see Samsung successfully hide it on the Galaxy Z Fold 5. Next, the single biggest issue with the Fold 4 is simply how much it costs, as this is one of the most expensive phones on the planet, almost making the iPhone 14 Pro Max look cheap by comparison. It's no surprise the price is high given the size of the screen and the tech involved, but if this foldable line is ever to be truly mainstream, then the price needs to drop, and we hope Samsung starts decreasing it with the Fold 5. Next, faster charging. Most Samsung phones have rather slow charging, and the Z Fold 4 is no exception. It tops out at 25 watts wired or 15 watts wireless, both of which are far lower than other flagships like the 150 watts OnePlus 10T or the 120 watts Xiaomi 12 Pro. We don't expect or need Samsung to reach those sorts of levels of charging power, but we'd like to at least see the Z Fold 5 split the difference and offer around 60 to 80 watts. At last, the bigger battery. Along with faster charging, we also like the Z Fold 5 to have a bigger battery. At 4400 mAh, the one in the Galaxy Z Fold 4 is average in size at best and actually smaller than the batteries in plenty of conventional phones. But given that this has a huge foldable screen, it could do with a particularly big battery. So at a minimum, we want a 5000 mAh one in the Z Fold 5. The Samsung Galaxy S22 Ultra has that, so it shouldn't be too much to ask for. So what are your expectations from Samsung's upcoming foldable? Share your thoughts below, and for more Galaxy news, you can check out our channel. See you for the next time. Peace out.